So I come from a Dalit community, which does not fall under the traditional Indian caste system. Till my 8th standard, that is 16 years, I have lived in a hut without any toilet. We used to go to some forest kind of area, and we have been living in such an environment. And my father, who wanted to make us all educated, to give a better educational environment, he made us to migrate from the slum to the city. Even in the practice, I was, you know, ignored, I was rejected, I was not allowed to take part as a lawyer in the court of law. So I, being a black, dark-skinned, you know, fat girl, in the Indian context, anyone can easily identify that I'm a Dalit. So it is not very hard for the judges to identify. If I go and argue a case, the judges will not be much interested to listen to my argument. When it comes to women, I want to make clear that we Dalit women never come under the category of women at all. The Indian nation or the feminist movement, they never consider Dalit women to be women at all. So the women issues, those are discussed in the international platform or in the mainstream media, are particularly about the dominant caste elite women who actually fight for the rights equal to men. When a woman is upset, when a woman is disturbed, then it is a reflection of the society. It means the society is unequal. So when you see an injustice, when you see a discrimination, when you see inequality, you have to rise up and raise your voice. So raising voice against any inequality, any discrimination, then you're setting peace in motion. Then you're working for the peace. So just stand up.